Hello friends, this video on Kingdom Animalia part 13 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So let us now move on to the next phylum, that is the platyhelminths. So what are platyhelminths? Their name itself tells something about it. Platy means flat. So these platyhelminths are also known as flatworms. So they are structure is flat. So we will talk about that little later. They have got even better body differentiation as compared to Cylindrata. So as we are moving ahead, you see the complexity is increasing. We started with Porifera, which was at a cellular level of organization. Then we came up with Cylindrata, which was at a tissue level of organization. Though the structure was little more complex. Now we have platyhelminths, which is even more complex than the Cylindrata. So here if we talk about symmetry, the body is bilaterally symmetrical. So if you look at this example which you see on the screen, this is planaria. So planaria is a platyhelminth. So in this, if you see that if you try to divide it along this axis, what do you see? It can be divided into a right and a left half, which will be identical to each other. Right? So it can be divided into equivalent right and left halves. That is why the body is bilaterally symmetrical. Body made of three layers of cells, that is why it is triploblastic. By now you all know what is diploblastic, what is triploblastic. So that means here they have three layers during their embryonic development: ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. Now as the number of layers increases, so the complexity or the organization of that organism will also increase, because ectoderm will form all the external things, endoderm will form some of the internal parts, the mesoderm will also form some part which will help in locomotion. No internal body cavity, that is acoelomate. So the coelom is absent even in case of platyhelminths. So you really don't have any cavity between the body wall and the gut wall. Talking about the number of species that exist for platyhelminths, almost around 13,000 species exist. These animals are generally soft bodied. I mean, they are not very hard or tough as far as their body is concerned. They are relatively soft bodied. Okay, some organs are present. Now, cells were there even in Porifera. In Cylindrata, tissues were there. Now, even some organs are also present there. Now, by looking at the planaria, you can say that it is a little more developed or it is a little more advanced as compared to Hydra. In Hydra, could you see anything like eye? Or could you see anything like mouth? Nothing, right? But here, at least by looking at this picture itself, you can see the eyes. So that means there are some organs which are little developed. So not all organs, but at least some organs are formed. And that is why it is said to be at organ level of organization. So a step forward. Body is flattened dorsiventrally. So what do we mean by dorsiventrally? From back to front. So the width of the body is very less, it is like flat. That is why they are often termed as flat worms. Cephalization is present. What do we mean by cephalization? It is the concentration of sense organs at anterior end. What do we mean by that? Let us take the example of human body. Have you ever observed that all our sense organs, what are the sense organs that we have? Eyes, ears, nose. You see, all of them are located on one side of our body. We do not have eyes at the top of our body and the ears at the feet. It is not like that. So all the sense organs are located towards one end of the body. And this phenomenon of concentration of all sense organs at one end is known as cephalization. So this cephalization was not present in very primitive animals like sponges or Cylindrata. But with platyhelminths, this cephalization started getting observed. So here you see the eyes are at one end. So this So this is known as cephalization, and that is why we say that cephalization was first seen in platyhelminths. They can be parasitic or free living. That means they can be they can depend on others, and they will live inside the body of another host and derive its food and nutrients from that host. So platyhelminths are, many of the platyhelminths actually are parasitic in nature. So these were some of the basic characteristics of platyhelminths. They are mobile. As I said, now you have all the three layers, ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm. So mesoderm is also there. So there will be some cells, the muscle cells or something, which will actually help in its movement. So they are mobile. Let us look at some examples of platyhelminths. Planaria, one of the very common and basic example. Liver flukes, the tapeworms, these are all examples of platyhelminths. Okay. So now with this basic idea, let us try to understand the structure of platyhelminths. Let us try to understand its organ level of organization. Because just now I told, right, it has organ level of organization because some organs are developed in platyhelminths. So let us see what are those organs which are developed and what are the functions that they perform. Okay, so let us start with the digestive system. Now, please remember, it is not at organ system level of organization. But when I am saying digestive system, I am trying to say, what is the substitute that these organisms have for their digestive system? How do they digest food? That is what I am talking about here. Now, when I talk about the digestive system, they have only one opening. So, what kind of digestive system do they have? I spoke about the types of digestive system, right? One is incomplete, the other one is complete. So when you have just one opening for ingestion and egestion, that type of digestive system is a incomplete digestive system. So these platyhelminths also have a similar type of digestive system where there is just one opening, which is the mouth. So where is the mouth here? So in this picture, you can see this is the mouth. So the intake of food will also happen through this, and the egestion, that is the removal of the wastes, will also happen through the same opening. It has a highly branched intestine. So where do you have the intestine? Now once the food enters through the mouth, it goes through this pharynx. So this is the pharynx. Now you can relate to all these terms when you compare it with the human digestive system. You know all these things, right? What is pharynx? What is intestine? What is stomach? Now, please don't expect that I'll explain you each of these terms here again, because that will consume a lot of time. And I have explained all these things when we were talking about the life processes in class 10th. So you can refer those videos. Okay, so this is the pharynx in case of planaria. Now, from the pharynx, this pharynx will connect it to the intestine somewhere here. So somewhere here, roughly, you will have the intestine, and this intestine is highly branched. So you have a lot of branches involved within the intestine. Talking about the next system, that is the excretory system. What do we have for excretion in case of platyhelminths? Now for excretion, they have got specialized cells which are known as phlegm cells. These phlegm cells are the specialized cells present in the platyhelminths, which help in excretion. That is, it helps in removal of the waste products from the body of the animal. Now, where are these phlegm cells present? Now, if you look at this organism, you see some gray colored tube-like structure. So this gray colored canal, which you see here, you see some canal, right? So they are nothing but, that is the excretory canal, and inside this excretory canals are present the phlegm cells. So inside that is present the phlegm cells. Then let us talk about the next system, that is the nervous system. So what do we have for nervous system? The nervous system is more organized. So now if you see here, we have the systems, but They are not well organized, and that is why. Now you might ask that when they have a rough digestive system, I mean somehow there is some digestive system with mouth, intestine, pharynx, etc. Again, it has an excretory system with some specialized cells for excretion. Then why is it that its level of organization is organ level and not organ system level? That could be a question in your mind. Now, you see here that they have some method to perform the function of each of the systems, but none of the systems are well organized or well complete. That is why they do not fall under the category of organ system level of organization, rather they fall under organ level of organization. So now, compared to the other systems, the nervous system is little more organized. Here cephalization is present, and as I said, in platyhelminths you will have the cephalization present, that is the sensory nerves will be, or the sense organs will be at one end of the body. They have a ladder like nervous system. What do you mean by a ladder like nervous system? Okay, so when I say ladder like nervous system, what do I mean? If you look at the structure of a planaria, how are the nerves present here? If you see here, here we have the nerve cords. So just beside the excretory canal, we also have the nerve cords running like this. Okay, so what are these? These are the nerve cords. Now on these nerve cords, we have ends like this, which are joined together like this. So this gave a ladder like appearance to the nervous system of the planaria. So what are these? These are, so here these two longitudinal cords which are running are the nerve cords. And these are known as the transverse nerves. So because of this kind of arrangement, it gives the appearance of a ladder. That is why it is said that the platyhelminth has a ladder-like nervous system. Now when I was talking about cephalization, what I meant was the head region is formed in these organisms, which houses the sensory organs and the brain. So where are the sensory organs? These are the sensory organs. So what are these? These are the eye spots, which helps in vision. Now just below the eye spots, you have the region which is the ganglia or the brain. Right? Okay. There are two long nerve cords which run throughout the body length, as I showed just now. And there are transverse nerves which connect the nerve cords. So these two arrangements together give it, so these two features together give it the appearance of a ladder-like. Simple brain or ganglia is present in the head region under the eye spots. So just now I mentioned these were the eye spots, and under the eye spots you have a simple brain, or which is often termed as ganglia. So now if you see, you have pretty much of things in the nervous system, right? You have the cords, you have the nerves, you also have a simple brain. So there are a couple of things which are there in the nervous system. Talking about the sensory organs, they also have specialized sensory organs present. What do you understand by sensory organs? Something which senses what is happening outside. Maybe vision, hearing, smell, taste. These are all the external senses. So those organs which can sense all these things are the sensory organs, or they are often known as receptors. So the special, the sensory organs which platyhelminths have are eye spots. These eye spots have photoreceptors, that is two pigmented areas in head that are sensitive to light. Photo means light, receptors means sensitive. So they are sensitive to light, so they can help them in vision. So again, if you see, these sensory organs are also present for the first time in platyhelminths. They were not present neither in Coelenterata nor in Porifera. Auricles present at the base of head, and that is sensitive to touch and certain chemicals. So where do you have auricles? So this is the auricle. This region is known as auricle, and this is sensitive to touch, like how our skin is sensitive to touch. And this is also sensitive to chemicals. So eye spots and auricles are the specialized sensory organs present in platy helminths. Okay, so now let us talk about reproduction. So how do these organisms reproduce? Now they can be unisexual or bisexual, that is both sexes in one organism or only one sex in one organism. So both ways are possible with platy helminths. Fertilization is internal, that is the fusion of the gametes take place inside their body. Talking about asexual reproduction, they can reproduce by regeneration. What is regeneration? It is little similar to fragmentation, but not the same thing. Now, fragmentation happens when an organism matures and it breaks into pieces. In this case, if the organism certainly meets some accident, and because of that accident it gets broken into pieces, then each of those pieces can give rise to a new individual. So this regeneration is an accidental process. So the platy helminths like planaria is capable of regeneration. So if by chance or by due to some accidental event, if this planaria gets broken into three parts, each of these parts will gradually give rise to an organism. So you actually get three organisms from one organism, right? So this is how it can reproduce asexually, by regeneration. So I think with this we have discussed the important parts of platy helminths. Thank you. Please visit www.examfear.com to watch more videos, attempt free online test, get free study material, find tutors and mentors. Thank you once again.